Good morning, children. Today we will discuss about ray optics representation. Ray optics representation. Let us go with the presentation. Let us see ray optics representation. Generally, we have single mode optical fiber and multi mode optical fibers. So here we will consider multi mode optical fibers. So as we know that core size of the multi mode optical fibers is much larger when we compared with the wavelength of light. That means which is approximately 1 micrometer. So here, as the rays are propagating through the optical waveguide, we can observe the meridional rays and also skew rays. That means here it is very simple to analyze these rays because we can observe in the geometrical representation. Here we can observe. So here in this present study, we will discuss only about meridional rays, but we won't discuss about skew rays. Why? Because these are helical in path. So, and it is very difficult to analyze these rays. So we will consider here meridional rays. So here again, these meridional rays, again it is divided into two types. So bound rays, unbound rays. And these meridional rays, they are confined to a single plane. They are confined to a single plane. But if you consider skew rays, they are not confined to a single plane. And it is very difficult to track these rays. And if you consider these rays, so here these involve in, and the skew rays will change such expressions such as light acceptance ability and also fiber and power losses of the light traveling along a waveguide. But and these are not confined to a single plane. And we will discuss this one about in another study. But today we will discuss only about meridional rays because these are confined to a single plane. And here we have again these meridional rays, we have unbound rays and also bound rays. And these bound rays that are trapped to a core and propagate along the fiber axis according to the laws of geometrical optics. But if you consider unbound rays, they are refracted out of the optical fiber core. They are refracted out of the fiber core. Now let us see the ray path projected on the fiber end face. So here this is the ray path. This is the representation of this dotted line represents the ray path. So this is the ray optics representation of a skew rays traveling in a step index optical fiber. These are traveling in a helical path here. So here a greater power loss arises when skew rays are included in the analysis. So whenever we have the skew rays, we can observe a loss. More loss can be obtained in the when the light are propagating along the optical fiber. So because many of the skew rays that geometrical optics predicts to be trapped in the fiber are actually leaky rays. That means here these rays are leaky rays. So these leaky rays are only partially confined to the core of the circular optical fiber and attenuate a light travels along the optical waveguide. So these are confined to the core of the circular optical fiber. And here we can attenuate as the light travels along the optical waveguide. That means we can observe a loss in the when the light travels along the optical waveguide. So this partial deflection of leaky rays cannot be described by pure ray theory alone. So we cannot discuss this one as a pure ray theory alone. So instead, so here we will discuss about the meridional rays here. So here the meridional rays, let us see. So the meridional rays which are in the step index optical fiber. So here we can see. So here the light ray enters the fiber core from the medium of the refractive index N. So here this is the ray entrance ray. So this here we can see. So here this is the cladding with refractive index N2. This is cladding refractive index N2. And this is the core. And this is the axis, optical fiber axis, and this is core refractive index, it is N1. So here as the ray is incident here, as the ray is incident on this, and which is here this is the fiber axis. So here the angle between this fiber axis and the incident ray is theta naught. And here we can observe the light ray which is incident on the core cladding interface boundary. So here this is the ray. Light ray, and here this is angle of incidence which is normal to this one, and the incident ray, this is the normal, And so the angle between the normal and the incident rate is phi. So here this is theta naught, and here the angle here between this axis and this one, it is theta. And here we can observe the rays which are less than the critical angle, so which are refracted. This is the dotted line, we can observe refracted here. So here we can observe some loss here. These are refracted out, and this is the acceptance cone. So here refractive index of the medium n, and here refractive index of the core, it is n1. Refractive index, it is n1. So refractive index of the medium, which is n, less than, it should be less than the refractive index of core refractive index, it is n1. So here let us see. So these are the meridional rain optics representation of the propagation mechanism in the ideal step index optical waveguide. So here by using the Snell's law, minimum or critical angle phi c. So critical angle phi c, that supports total internal reflection for the meridional ray, which is given as sine phi c, which is equals to n2 by n1. So here n2 it is refractive index of the cladding, and n1 it is refractive index of the core. So here minimum or critical angle phi c supports the total internal reflection for the meridional rays, which is equals to sine phi c, which is equals to n2 by n1. So here, so rays striking in the core cladding interface at angles less than phi c will refract out of the core. Already we have seen this is the refraction here. So going out, so it escapes from this core, and we can observe the loss in the from the outside cladding here. Refract out of the core and be lost in the cladding. So it represents the dashed line. So by applying Snell's law to the air fiber phase boundary, the condition can be seen from equation 2.21, can be related to the maximum entrance angle theta naught maximum, which is called the acceptance angle theta a, through the relationship. So here by using this one, so sine phi c, which is equals to n2 by n1. So here the relation between the maximum entrance angle theta naught maximum, which is also called the acceptance angle theta a. So by using the relationship, we have n sine theta naught maximum. So sine theta naught maximum, which is equals to theta a, acceptance angle. So n sine theta naught maximum equals to n sine theta a, which is equals to n1 into sine theta c, which is equals to n1 square minus n2 square whole power 1 by 2. So here theta c, which is theta c, is equals to pi by 2 minus pi c. So thus the rays having entrance angle theta naught less than theta a will be totally internal reflected at core cladding interface. That means here, whenever we are seeing here the rays having entrance angle theta naught which is less than theta a will be totally internally reflected. So here if you see here, here we can observe some refracted rays, and this is the incident ray, and here we can observe some reflected. So see here. So rays having entrance angles theta naught less than theta a will be totally internally reflected at the core cladding interface. So thus theta a depends on acceptance cone for the optical fiber. So this equation also defines the numerical aperture Na, which is represented by Na of a step index optical fiber for meridional rows, is given as numerical aperture, which is equals to n into sine theta a, which is equals to n1 square minus n2 square whole power 1 by 2, which is approximately equal to n1 root of 2d, 2 delta, root of 2 delta. So approximation on the right hand side, which is valid for the typical case where delta defined by equation a, which is much less than 1. So since the numerical aperture is related to the acceptance angle, already we have seen, so it is commonly used to discuss the light acceptance or gathering capability of a fiber, and to calculate force to fiber optical power coupling efficiencies. So we can see in another chapter 5. So numerical aperture is, which is a dimensionless quality. Numerical aperture is a dimensionless quality, so which is less than unity, that means which is less than 1, and its values is ranging from 0.14 to 0.50. So here this is about the optic representation. Thank you, children.